Hello students, so today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is the chemical coordination in plants. Okay, this chapter is quite very interesting because this chapter is quite related to the hormone secretion, and we have already completed up the hormone parts, but the hormone which we have completed was related to the humans. Okay, but these hormones will be related to the plants. So let's start. The first, what do you mean by the plant hormones? Plant hormones are those hormones which get stimulate means get produced, okay, where it gets produced inside the plants and shows up some of the movement. Okay, this movement word is very specific. Why this movement word is very specific? Because I just wanted to give you an example that the plant shows the movement. Okay, the plant shows the movement, but it does not shows locomotion. What does that means? See, there is a difference between a word of movement and a locomotion. What is the main difference between a movement and a locomotion? Let's understand. Movement, the word movement means, like, suppose in humans I'm talking about, like waving of your hands, it's a movement. But what do you mean by locomotion? Locomotion means moving from one place to another. So, students, I just wanted to ask, as we are studying about the plants will show definitely movement, like it is going to respond to you. Okay, movement like growth of the plant. Okay, whenever you touch up the plants, at that period of a time, it gets closed in mimosa pudica, or you can also call it as touch me not plant. But plant does not show locomotion. What does that mean? Like the plant does not move from one place to another. So this was about the plant hormones, that it shows up the movements. See, let's take an example. If suppose there is a cup of tea which is very hot, and suppose I try to touch it up with my hands. If I try to touch with my hands, so what is going to happen? I am immediately going to remove my hand. Why? Because this cup of tea is too hot. Okay, so how we came to know that this cup of tea was too hot? Because there are, you have already heard about this word, there are nerves present inside our hands. Nerves, okay, this nerves sense that okay, this is too hot, and you have to remove your hands, which has been getting commanded from your brain. So inside the humans, who was responsible for all this movement? There were the nerves. Now a question arises, does the plants have nerves? The answer is no. Then how does the plants can assume the sensitiveness? Okay, this is due to the chemical control. This is due to the chemical control, which is known as the hormone. In easier one, chemical control means all the possibility factors which can be getting controlled by the plants is done through the chemicals, and these chemicals are nothing but the hormones, as we have already completed this in the endocrine as well. So as the plant does not have the nerves, then too it can also respond to the things. Why? Due to this presence of the hormone. As this is the plant hormones, okay, so it has been termed as the phytohormone also. It has been also called as the phytohormones. Why this is called as the phytohormones? See, the word phyto means plant. Okay, the hormone which is related to plants are called phytohormones. These are very essential. So as I have given the example, okay, this was a cup of tea which is quite hot. This cup of tea was steamy. Okay, and removing of my hand while touching this hot cup of tea was the response from my side. So same like that, तो सेम लाइक दैट इवन द प्लांट शो सच काइंड ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सेज. लाइक देर इज अ स्टिमुली. ओके, वॉट इज अ स्टिमुली? इट्स एन एक्सटर्नल और द इंटरनल एनवायरमेंट ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, दिस इज एन एक्सटर्नल. ओके, एंड रिस्पॉन्सेज लाइक रिमूविंग हैंड इज द रिस्पॉन्स. तो सेम लाइक दैट. तो आई हैव गिवन द एग्जाम्पल टू यू. सपोज दिस इज अ मीमोसा लिव्स. ओके, यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दिस इन द अब्सॉर्प्शन बाय रूट. दिस इज द मीमोसा प्यूडिका प्लांट. ओके, यू शुड नो दिस नेम, प्यूडिका नेम, मीमोसा प्यूडिका. तो वॉट हैपन्स, मीमोसा प्यूडिका इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड हैज टच मी नॉट प्लांट. तो वॉट इज गोइंग टू हैपन वेन एवर वी टच अप दिस प्लांट? तो आफ्टर फ्यू मिनट्स सी दिस पॉइंट. अज्यूम वॉट इज हैपनिंग आउट हियर. दिस इज द ओपन लीफ बट दिस इज द क्लोज लीफ. सो नाउ अ क्वेश्चन अराइजेस, एज दिस वॉज ओपन हाउ डिड द लीव्स गॉट क्लोज्ड? बाय टचिंग. तो दे वर सेंसिटिव, राइट? द स्टिम्युली, द टच वॉज द स्टिम्युली एंड द रिस्पॉन्स इट मेड वॉज क्लोज. ओके, द टच वॉज द स्टिम्युली एंड द क्लोज ऑफ द लीव्स इज द रिस्पॉन्स विच हैज बीन डन बाई द प्लांट्स. सो इवन दिस इज एन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर. इवन यू विल कम टू नो हाउ द प्लांट्स वर्क, हाउ द प्लांट ग्रोज, हाउ देर इज अ फॉलिंग ऑफ द लीव्स, हाउ डज द फ्रूट गेट फॉर्म. ओके, तो सी there are different types of the plant hormones, or you can also call it as a phytohormones. What are they? They are the auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, ethylene, abscisic acid. These are the 5 important hormones, and each of the hormones have their own specific function. As in the condition of the humans, we were having the pancreas, we were having the pituitary glands, okay, thyroid glands, adrenal glands, even these are the 5 important hormones. So let's discuss with the first one, that is the auxin. Where is this auxin is present? So first, what do you mean by the word auxin, and who has given this term? There was a scientist, okay, he was a botanist whose name was F.W. Wendt. Here, auxin is a Greek word which means to grow. So see, the name only suggests. The auxin means what? To grow in English language. And auxin itself is a Greek word. What does to grow means? This auxin is nothing but the powerful growth stimulants. Okay, it is a powerful growth stimulant. Growth stimulants means what? It helps us the plant to grow. Okay, in easy language, it helps the plants to grow. These auxins are present in each and every plant. Okay, in each and every plant. The best one and the natural auxin which is found in the plants is called IAA. IAA. What does IAA means? Indole 3-acetic acid. Okay, this is very important. Okay, this is very important what I'm writing. That is IAA. They might ask you in the abbreviation question. Okay, in the year 2018, they have asked this question. Okay, what is the full form of IAA? So that is indole 3-acetic acid. This auxin is also called as IAA, and this is the main and the natural auxin which is found in the plants. So you should know this part. Now we are going to study more about the auxins. So first, where are these auxins are present? These auxins are primarily present in the root, stem and the shoot system. Okay, suppose
this is the surface, okay, this is the root system, and suppose this is the shoot system, okay. Where are these auxins are present? In the tip. Tip part means like this, tip means at the top, at the tip of the shoot system, and this is the root part. So, and this is the tip of the shoot, tip of root and tip of shoot, these are present.
So basically they helps the plant to grow from the upward, I mean to say from the shoot system, and from the downward, that means from the root system as well, okay. And this region,
where this region is called the meristem. You have already studied up this word meristem in your 9th standard in the chapter called tissue. What do you mean by meristems? Which can get actively divided, okay. This is the actively growing part. Now there are basic different functions of the auxin.
The first, what is the function of the auxin? The auxin promotes the growth of the stems, roots and the fruits by the cell elongation. What does that mean?
The first, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a plant cell for you, okay. We know this is a plant cell, okay. I'm not going to make any of the organelles. I'm just going to explain you, okay, what I'm making. The outermost part of the plant cell is called cell wall, okay. And this auxins, where are these present? These are present somewhere here. Okay.
These are present somewhere here. Okay.
So what does they do? See. So I have shown up where are the auxin present. Okay. In the plant cell. What does that happen? See. Suppose this is a plant cell wall. When these auxins are produced in a greater number, now what is going to happen? See, now what is going to happen? This cell wall gets stretched. This cell wall gets stretched up. See this part and see this part. Why? Because there were more amount of the auxin, okay, which helps the cell wall to get increased. So when the cell wall got increased, so at that period of a time, there was a cell elongation which was taking place. What does that mean? Cell elongation means the cell size was getting increased, and due to this, it was helping in the growth part. Suppose, let's understand perfectly. Suppose this is the plant, okay, and these are the auxin which are present on the tip part of the juice. If suppose I am going to increase the amount of auxin, okay, I am going to increase the amount of auxin, then what is going to happen? This plant is going to get big. This plant is going to get big, and more amount of the auxin you can see out here. So what does this suggest? This suggests that the rate of elongation is proportional to the auxin concentration. What does that mean? Cell elongation is directly proportional to the auxin concentration. What does that mean? See, if more the auxin get produced, auxin, the cell will get more elongated. If the auxin level is less, the cell elongation level will be less.
Okay, so basically auxin helps in the growth of the stem, roots and the fruits. Now auxin delays leaf senescence. Okay, what do you mean by the word senescence? The word senescence means aging. okay, aging of the leaf, aging or the falling of the leaves. See, generally what happens when the plants grow, okay, so at the particular period of a time, they stop to grow, okay. At that period of a time, the plants get old and they start to, and in that plants, the leaf starts to fall. So at that period of a time, this auxin helps in delays in the leaf senescence. It helps to prevent from the aging, okay. It helps the plants to get old. This auxin, it keeps it healthy. Now, a very important concept is going to come. That is the apical dominance. This is a very important one, okay. And this is so. And this question, that is the apical dominance, have been asked in the board question and in the many school prelim papers also they have asked. Okay, what do you mean by the word apical dominance? So apical, the first we will understand the word apical. Apical means the topmost part, okay, tip. That is the root and the shoot system, okay. And I have already shown, okay, where are the auxins? They are on the tip of the root and the shoot, okay. So what do you mean by the dominance word? Let's understand. See, so first I'm going to make a soil surface, then I'm going to make up the roots, okay, then I'm going to make up the shoot system. Where are these auxins? These auxins are somewhere here and here. As these auxins are present on the top side, it helps to elongate it vertically like this. And as these auxins are present in the shoot system here, so it helps to grow downward as well, upward and downward. But it does not, this auxin does not allow, this auxin does not allow the plants to grow horizontally like this, like from the stem I am talking about, okay. It does not allow them to grow from the stem region. It only allows them to grow from the root system, shoot system and from the root system, but not from the stem region. Why? This is the concept called the apical dominance. What does apical dominance means? Apical dominance means the phenomena of suppression of growth of the lateral buds by the apical buds. What does that mean? Suppose there are more auxins out here, so it will help to grow upward, not the sideways, okay. The word lateral means side, from side I'm talking. It is not going to allow them to grow from the sideways, it is just going to help them to grow from the upward position, okay. So this suppression means stopping of the lateral growth, okay, stopping of the lateral growth. But what happens in the case of the bonsai? In the case of the bonsai, the plants are very small. What does they do? This is the top part and they try to cut it out, okay. And because of this, the plants get short and they try to get elongated from the sidewards like this. Why they try to elongate it from the sidewards? Because this auxin region has been removed, and because of this, there is the only growth we can see from the sideways in the case of the bonsai. Even the auxins are present in the bonsai, but what does they do? They cut the topmost part. So that is why the bonsais are very dwarf plants, okay. They are very small in size. Now next function, that is the parthenocarpy. Even this is way too important, okay. What do you mean by the word parthenocarpy? The word parthenocarpy means the seed, the fruits which are without the seeds. Fruits without the seeds, okay. Some of the fruits, they are without the seeds. This term is called as the parthenocarpy, okay. Where you are going to see this part? In apples, tomato, banana. Many of them are got confused, sir, how it is possible? In the tomatoes we can see of the seeds, but this parthenocarpy is a condition. It can be occur naturally also, or it can be occur artificially also. This is the property of the auxin.
okay, this is the property of the auxin, that it can produce of the fruits without the seeds. So it can be artificially also, by giving the plants the injection, or it can be natural also. So this was all about the auxin parts. Let's see some of the diagrams related to the auxin. See, as I already said, where is this auxin present? On the topmost part. And what is this? This is a light. Which light? Sunlight. And now this auxin gets spread equally down sides of the plant. So see, when there is a more amount of the auxin get produced in the meristem, this get actively divided and it transferred to the different parts. Okay, now because of this they are bending towards the light and the auxin is getting divided out here, okay, getting spread. As the plants become big, they try to bend towards the light. Okay, so when they try to bend toward the light, the auxin hormones also get distributed in this region. So that is why they try to grow in the vertical direction. And this is a parthenocarpic condition. So here see, I will read for you. If pollination, we have already studied this part in your 9th standard. If pollination occurs, it goes with the fertilization. And then there is a formation of fruit and seed. But suppose there can be a condition like this also. If no pollination is going to occur, so definitely no fertilization is going to occur. So how does the fruit will get the seeds? So this is a seedless. We can't see any of the seeds. Okay. Now, gibberellins. This is the second hormone. See, first gibberellins. Even these are the growth hormone only. Even these are the same as the auxin only. Even the functions, if you are going to read, it would be same only. Okay, you won't be seeing any of the differences in the functions. Gibberellins. There are different forms of gibberellins. That is gibberellins GA1. Okay. That is GA2 and GA3. But most abundant gibberellic acid, GA stands for gibberellic acid, okay? But the most abundant and the most studied form of the gibberellin is GA3, okay? They might ask you in the fill in the blank, okay, which is the most founded gibberellin. So that is GA3. Okay, even these gibberellins are present in the marismatic region, like the stem apex, root apex. Okay, but there is a difference between the function of the gibberellins and the auxin. Let's understand. See, as I said, the gibberellins also is a growth hormone. But what is the difference between the auxin and the gibberellins? First, understand that part, and then we will come to the different points of the gibberellins. See, the main function of the gibberellin is to promote the growth of internodes by the cell elongation. Suppose I'm making up a plant. This is one, another branch, one branch, and like this. Okay, these are the branch. What do you mean by the word internode? Internode means the space, the word inter means between, okay, the space between the two branches. See, this is the space which has been called as the internodes, okay, the space between the two nodes, okay, between the two branches are called the internodes. When these gibberellins are produced in excessive amount, then what is going to happen? See this part. We can see and we can compare. Suppose this is A and compare this with B. So we can see in the B, thus the growth of the internodes. have been elongated, okay, by the cells. So this gibberellins helps in the growth of the internodes. So basically this is one of the major differences.
Now a question arises,
okay, suppose I give you a seed.
Suppose I give you a seed and you put that seed into the soil. So after few days, what happens? Inside the seed there is an embryo which is in dormant state. Dormant means what? Inactive state. So when this gibberellins is produced perfectly, the seed starts to germinate. So there would be a formation of the shoot system and there is a formation of the root system from this seeds, okay. So gibberellins also helps to break the seed dormancy, means the inactive state of the seed, okay, and it helps in initiating of germination. Now even this gibberellins helps to promote the fruit growth and are capable of inducing parthenocarpy. What does that means? Same like the auxins, even this gibberellins have this part that it produce of the fruits without the seeds. They also help in delay senescence, means aging part. Gibberellins are widely used in the horticulture part, okay. What does horticulture means? Horticulture means the art of cultivation of fruits, vegetables, okay, fruit, vegetable, flowers, etc. But this horticulture is specially done in the technical field, like in the research field it is done. Why? Because they have to carry out the research to produce the better varieties, okay. So this is basically horticulture is done for the research part, okay. So it can be termed as a agriculture, because agriculture is carried out in the field and which is not natural. But horticulture is not natural because it has been practiced in the labs. These hormones also enhance the longitudinal growth of the internode in the dwarf plants. There are dwarf plants like bonsai, I've said. Okay, if the internodes get increased, they could look tall. They are used commercially to increase the length of the grapes. I just wanted to give an example so that the thing goes in your head. If suppose you have seen a plant, natural plant, that is of grapevine. It is like full perfect circle. This is a grape, okay, which has been natural. But by producing of this gibberellins, the size of the grapes increase like this. There is a difference between this shape and this shape. This shape is perfectly a circle, I can talk, but this is not perfectly a circle. So how does this changes took place? Due to the help of the gibberellins, okay, because this gibberellins helps to increase the length of the grapes and helps to elongate and improve their shape as well. So whenever you buy the grapes commercially, you can see there is an increase in the size of the grapes, okay. It is gibberellin acid is also used in the brewing industry, like in the coffee tea industries. So today we are going to just complete up this two hormones, that is the auxin and the gibberellins. So this was the part 1 of chemical coordination. Thank you, students.